All right.
All right.
Here we go. Okay, so the first thing were these different activities, if you remember. You have to give a score between 0 and 10 for an activity, and 0 means there's no way I can do it, and 10 means no problem at all. I have no problem doing that. So the first activity that needs a number is to do some strength training in the gym for 1.5 hours.
Okay, I would say 7.
And the next would be a full day at work.
Four.
And a day with friends at a cafe and shopping.
Five.
And to read for 4 hours studying.
Six.
Yeah. And a full night out from 8 until 3 in the morning.
Six.
Okay. All right. So it looks like we have the first improvement here. So when we did this the first time, your total score for all of this put together was 12, and now it's 28. So it's more than double on your activity, your ability to do the different things. So that's very good.
Yes,
Yes.
it's
Yeah. Okay, so far so good. So the next thing is your top three worst symptoms in the last week. So if, what would be, what is the worst symptom you've had the last week?
it's probably headache right here
Yeah,
between my
between the
brows.
eyes. Yeah.
Pain in the eyebrows and pain in temples.
Yeah.
So it's mostly just in the upper head.
Yeah, okay. All right. And then the next part is then we have the different pains. And again, you have to give a number between 0 and 10, but here it's the other way around. So if you give 10, it means it's very, very bad. And if you get 0, it means you haven't had this symptom. And we're looking at around the last week, maybe the last 2 weeks, something like that. So the first one is pain in the back of the head.
Two.
Yeah. And pain behind the ear.
Two.
And pain in the temples or over the ear.
Yeah, six.
And pain in the forehead. So we,
Yes, I would say four.
yeah. Okay. And when you say four, you mean only the forehead and not between the eyes. Is that right?
Yes,
Yeah.
exactly.
Okay. Because actually we don't have one specifically for between the eyes. How this number between the eyes, how was that in the beginning? Is that a new symptom or has that always been there?
No, it's new.
It's a new.
Most of the headache was just up here before. It's like it's going
It's going
downwards.
down. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to put in a new symptom here, but we have to give it also a number for if you have to try to remember back in the time and see how much it was because we have to measure it all the way. It might not be perfect, but let's try pain between eyes. So how much would you give that today?
Today,
Or
six.
the last couple of or two, 1 or 2 weeks. Six, yeah. And then when we started, how much would you, if you can remember back, and I know it's difficult, but just some kind of number.
Two, three.
Three?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. All right, because then we have put in this number, so we get a more correct measurement. Okay, so the next one is pain on top of the head.
One.
Yeah. And pain in the back teeth.
Zero.
Yes. And pain in the jaw.
Zero.
And pain in the eyes.
Four.
And then we have actually something called sinus pain, and that's in Danish it's bihulerne. So it's a little bit inside, more inside of the head. But I don't know if that's the same as pain between the eyes for you.
Maybe, because I do have some pain just around the eyes too.
Yeah.
So.
So if I say pain in the sinus, I bihulerne, how much? Yeah. Let's just. How much would you give that?
Five.
Five. Okay. And pain inside the ear.
Zero.
And pain in the throat, inside the throat. Zero. Yeah. And pain in the chest.
Zero.
And pain in the neck.
Four.
And pain in the base of the skull, kranjekanten.
Three.
And pain in the upper back, so it's just below the neck area.
Two.
And then we have pain between the shoulder blades, so further down.
One.
And then we have pain in the middle of the back.
Zero.
And pain in the lower back or linden.
Zero.
Yeah. And then we have pain on the top of the shoulder.
Zero.
Yes. And pain inside or on the side of the shoulder.
Zero.
Yes. And pain in the upper arm.
Zero.
And pain in the lower. Do you have anything in the arms and hands and fingers at all?
No. Yep. Nothing.
All right. Okay, and then we have tinnitus.
Zero.
And sensitivity to sounds.
Three, four.
Yeah, and how do you experience that? And what kind of situation could that be?
For example, if there's a lot of people talking.
Yeah, okay.
Too many noises and yeah.
Yeah, okay. So four.
Yeah.
Yeah. And sensitivity to light.
Two.
And trouble swallowing.
Zero.
Yeah. And watery eyes or dry eyes.
Three.
And clicking of the jaw or mechanical issues with the jaw.
I don't really know because my jaw is always clicking, but it's not hurting, so.
Okay. So.
Let's say zero.
Yeah, okay. Because I mean, mine also, if I do like this, I can hear it when I open it, like,
okay.
But okay, yeah. And nausea?
Zero.
And dizziness and balance disturbances?
Zero.
And irritation in the eyes?
Zero.
And irritation in the nose?
Zero.
And trouble turning the head?
Zero.
And visual disturbances?
Zero.
And a feeling of living in jelly or living in a dream?
Two.
Mm-hmm. and inability to concentrate.
Four.
And inability to sleep, poor sleep quality, like it's difficult to fall asleep, or four. Yeah, four. And a feeling of stress or anxiousness.
Six, seven, around.
Seven. And tiredness or a lack of energy. All right. Okay, perfect. So that was actually all the symptoms. Yes, but it's looking good, Line. You now have 50% reduction in your symptoms.
Really?
Yes. So it's going the right way.
Is.
Yeah, very good. So when we started this, the total was 142, and now it's only 71. Yes. So some of the good ones, let me see if I can find some that have fallen a lot. So top shoulder pain has gone from 6 to 0. Pain between the shoulder blade has gone from 5 to 1. Pain in the border of in the base of the skull from 6 to 3. Pain in the neck from 9 to 4. Pain in the eyes from 10 to 4. Pain on top of the head from 8 to 1.
Shit.
And the pain in the forehead from 10 to 4. And pain in the back of the head from 7 to 2. So that's very good. There are a few ones that have increased a little bit, like, the one between the eyes anything else. Yeah, actually, sound sensitivity. This is why I ask you about sound sensitivity. Because the first one we did, your sound sensitivity was only 2, and then last time we did it was 0, and then today it's 4. But it's fine that it can go a little bit up. It's going to drop away completely in the end.
I think it's because I find it triggering
Yeah.
my
Your
so
headaches and
yeah.
yeah. But all in all, fantastic result. Line, so you
Yes.
are on the right way, so soon you will be healed.
We hope so.
Yes. So very good. I'll stop the recording now.